of the morning.
And teach them to love one another. Heaven might find a place in their heart.
I'm truly blessed, man, to be able to come back.
Yes, sir.
We go to 20 different prisons.
Amen.
Women and men. And my motive is to encourage y'all brothers and anybody.
All right, right.
That God can help us to change our life.
Yeah.
We can change our life. Amen. We don't have to stay the same.
Thank you.
hero. But I ask a question, Lord. I said, Lord, who are so much pain for he.
Take us,
people that and have us doing things that we've never in our fondest, our farthest imagination could have ever dreamed.
No.
Yes, sir.
That we'd be doing.
Yes,
if somebody a while back had told me I'd be standing here on this evening,
right,
I said, no way in the world.
Lord, yes, Lord.
Not because of God, but because I knew me.
Right. Yeah, right.
And I knew I wasn't nothing.
All right.
Amen. Amen. Matter of fact, I was at my job at the Herman Park Regional Center when God called me to preach, and I said, Lord, I can't do that.
Right.
I said, Lord, I ain't nothing.
Right.
Yes, sir. I said, I've been low down and dirty, and I've been nasty, and I've done some things that I wouldn't want anybody to ever know about. And the Lord spoke to me and said, I've seen every low-down, dirty thing
you would ever
do. He said, but I didn't let nothing happen
to
you. I kept you. Because I knew that one day I was going to use you for my glory.
No, sir.
He said, but if you would just stand, I'll wash you.
Yes, sir. Amen.
You see, we're all a work in progress. Everybody here is in different stages of perfection. And God knows the plans he has for you. So there is a word from the Lord on this evening. For some, it's probably familiar passage of scripture. It seems strange, but it's in the book of Psalms. Psalm 40 says, I waited patiently for the Lord. And he inclined unto me and heard my cry. He brought me up also out of a horrible pit, out of the miry clay, and set my feet upon a rock and established my goings. The grass will, the flower will fade, but the word of our God shall stand forever. Father, we thank you right now for this opportunity to stand before your people, realizing that there's a word that you want to impart into all of our spirits on this evening. Father, I pray right now that you take this flawed vessel of clay, fill it full of your precious Holy Ghost, fill it with your word, and speak to your people, oh God. Father, I pray for every soul gathered in this place right now, Father, that you would allow their hearts to be open to receive that you have for them, that we will receive your word, mix it with faith, put action to it, and see it bring about a harvest in each and every one of our lives. And we thank you for it all in Jesus' name. Amen. When I started looking at this, I waited patiently on the Lord, and I know Brooks told me you all are having a revival, and the word revive means to bring something back to life that has once been dead. Amen. So and then they have revivals like this, then they have soul saving revivals. So I think ours is kind of a combination. And when I read this passage of scripture, first of all, he said, I waited patiently for the Lord. Now, there's a lot of waiting going on. I'm sure you all are well aware of that. We got a lot of waiting going on. We're all waiting for different things, but this, the psalmist says, I waited patiently, but my mind went back to a time when I was in Target store in Houston. It was the holiday season, and you know how long the lines are? I had to stand in line a long time, and I was beginning to get impatient. And a little voice on the inside of me spoke and said, nah, you got to wait.
Come on, son.
You can do it mad, or you can do it glad, but you still got to wait. And I'm telling you all this evening, you got to wait. Now, how you wait is up to you. You can wait mad, or you can wait glad, but you still got to wait. But I found out there is a purpose in waiting. There's a purpose in it. I'm serving leader of the intercessory prayer team at my church. I'm in charge of the prayer. My heart beat is prayer.
Yes, sir.
I believe that I don't care what's going on, I
can conquer it through the word of God and prayer. I really believe that. I believe it. And so I get prayer requests constantly from Minister Brooks when they go to the jails and different places. They bring me the prayer requests and I read them. And I find a common thread through every prayer request.
Yes, sir.
I hear pray for my children. They're out and I'm not with them. And pray for my wife. Pray for my mother. She's going to have surgery. But the number one prayer request I get is pray I'm going before the board.
All right.
And pray that I'll be released. And I thought about that. And you know, I know we don't want to wait. But there's a purpose in waiting.
That's right.
I'm going to propose to you on this evening a different prayer.
Yeah.
And say, Lord, touch the parole board. Lord, touch the hearing. Yeah. Why don't we pray, Lord, change me?
Yeah. Yeah.
Lord, change me.
He will.
You see, I found out that my enemy is in me. So if my enemy is in me, me has got to change.
Yes, sir.
He said that I waited patiently.
Mm-hmm.
Because in that waiting time, God wants to change us.
Right.
You see, I feel like a few times I went to jail, I didn't do no more in county jail, you know, my little stuff I was doing, but I would get out, and 6 months later, I was back in again. And when I would get in, all I could think about was calling some family member or somebody to come with some bail, but I never realized that the reason I was where I was because of the way I was thinking and the decisions that I kept on making. That's what had me where I was. So God said, I know many of us, when we were out, we were moving fast. We were going here, and we were going there, and we had all this going, and we didn't have time for God. We, you know, when we were locked down, yes, we were praising God, and but all our focus in praising God many times was to get God to act on our behalf. And be in the loving God that He is. He heard, He hears our cries. And He does answer. But the unfortunate thing is, I haven't changed on the inside. So when I got back, I had my mind made up. I said, I'm not going where I used to go. I'm not going to deal with that same group of people that I was dealing with, but because my mind hadn't changed. I wanted to do better. But because the inner man was the same as he was before, I looked up, and before I knew anything, I was right back with the same group, doing the same thing, ending up in the same place. One of my favorite movies of all time is Shawshank Redemption. My other one is Forrest Gump, but we never watched that. But I love Shawshank Redemption. And the character Red. You know, Red was the man that whatever you need in the penitentiary, Red could get it for you. For so many packs of cigarettes, you could get anything. And so Red had committed murder in his young days. He caught his old lady and another man out. He handled his business. Wasn't in the proper way, but he handled it. He ends up with a life sentence. So ever so often he keeps going before the parole board, and they ask him, they said, are you reformed? And he said, oh yeah, I'm ready. I'm reformed. And they put stamp denied. Years so late, he'd come back and they'd ask him again. He'd go through it year after year after year. But finally, one year, he went up before the parole board and they said, are you reformed? He said, what is reformed? He said, it's a made up word so young fellows like you can put on a suit and push a pencil around the papers and have a job.
Right. Yeah.
He said, but if you want to know if I regret what I did, he said, I wish I could go back and talk to that young man that didn't have no sense.
Right.
And tell him the way you were planning to go is the way of destruction.
Yes, sir.
I wish I could shake some sense into him. So reform, I don't know. He said, as far as you let me out of, he said, I really don't give a damn. Do whatever you want to do. And the next scene, they show his file being stamped. Approved. Parole. Why was the change? Because he was no longer bound by prison bars. The prison within him sold his soul. He had been released from that prison. And when the release on the inside comes, there's got to be a release on the outside. One of the hardest days of my life was when I had to admit to myself finally that where you are today is a result of the decisions that you made. It ain't got nothing to do with the fact that your father wasn't the father that he should be, that he disrespected your mother. Your mother died when you were 13. It ain't got nothing to do with that. In the condition that I was. And then I had to say, Lord, how do I change? I don't know how to change. I've been like this all my life. But I did begin to pray. And I prayed one prayer every day. Lord, fix me. Fix me. I'm broke. I'm shattered. One time I had an appliance at my house that broke, and I finally got smart. I tried everything I could to fix that appliance, but it didn't work. But one day I got a divine revelation from heaven. I picked up the handbook. Manufacturer to try to find out how your life is supposed to amount of time.
Right.
How will I know when I'm ready? Mm-hmm. They said that there were some people that went to a gold refiner shop. He had the gold in the fire. Mm-hmm. And some of us are in the fire now.
Right now.
And they asked him, they said, well, how do you know when the gold is pure?
Yeah.
He said, when I can look at it and see my reflection.
Yeah.
So God is saying, when I can look at you,
and
I can see my reflection, the one I created you to be, coming forth, then I know you are ready. And when you get ready, you don't have to go to the law You ain't got to get no prison attorney to try to get this. You don't have to get that. You don't have to get the other. That was a young man in the prison by the name of Joseph. And he had no chance of pardon or parole. But God allowed him to go through a pit. Then to work for a man called Potiphar. Then he allowed him to be put in the prison for something that he didn't even do. But when it came time for God to bring him out, there was something God had put on the inside of him that nobody else had. And Pharaoh needed just what was on the inside that God had put on Joseph. So it wasn't nothing that Joseph had to do. When God gets ready to lift you up out of the book and the mouth, you don't have to do that. In this country that weren't slaves. Had no education, had no money, had no political clout. But they had one thing. The master messed up and told them about Jesus. No matter how long it takes. He's a God that you can't hurt. But he'll be there.
Yes.
Don't you worry.
Yes,
he may not come when you want him.
Always.
But he's always right on time.
Always.
Now take it today. Don't try to rush God. Begin to ask God to work on the inside of you. To change you. To make you to be what he'd have you to be. And when he does that, he'll cause the prison doors to open. He'll call it. They'll be calling your name to go home and you'll be wondering why. Because God has need of you. God has need of you, young man. God has need of you. God created you
with a purpose.
I had a young man to me. I thought God created me to mess up. God, you a liar, the devil, I'm lying to you. God ain't created nobody to mess up. Instead, Jesus said that he made us a kings and priests. We are a royal priesthood and a holy nation.
That's right.
In the scriptures it said that he has created us just a little bit lower than the angels. But I'm going to tell you that's a bad translation. That ain't what the original Hebrew text says. The original Hebrew text says he created us a little lower than Elohim. Who is Elohim? God! Angels for our service. The problem is you don't know who you are. You bought the devil's life. You are not what you've done. You have been magnificently created in the very image and likeness of God. It's not Jesus Christ your brother. But anybody here got a brother that's on four legs as a dog? Come on! If you are created in his image, you are a God-like creation.
Yes, sir.
Now perhaps you lost your way.
You will.
Perhaps you bought the word, the lie of the devil.
Alright.
That you ain't nothing, but that's a lie. Do you think Jesus, he is God incarnate, would have come down out of heaven to die for a wretch, for something that ain't nothing?
Yes, sir.
The angels fail, and there's no repentance. Think about that. We fail, and God came from heaven and died for us. For us, what he didn't do for angels.
No, sir.
You are more than a conqueror.
Yes, sir.
It's what's on the inside of you. All you see is a earth suit. That's all you see. But the real me is on the inside. That's created in the very image and likeness of God. The real me is created to never grow old. The real me is created to live forever with God. To rule and reign with Christ. If there's anyone here tonight that wants to accept Christ as Lord, it's not a hard thing. It's only a matter of saying, Father, I want you. I'm sorry for the way I'm living. I want a new life. That's all you got to do. That's all. I know it sounds too easy, though. But the way is so easy that even a fool can get it. He fixed it that way. So, Mr. Russell, you come. Let's do a closing prayer. I hope you got something tonight. Something that'll help you. Father God, we thank you right now. We thank you for this opportunity to share. We thank you for these, your sons, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
We thank you for them tonight. God, work in their lives as never before. Change us, oh God, into what it is that you would have for us to be. We don't know what we're supposed to be, but you know. So change us. Give us new life in Christ.
Thank you.
And we thank you for it all right now in the name of your son Jesus. We do pray. Amen.
Amen.
Hey, I want to let y'all know, pray for my pastor. He's in the hospital. He's supposed to preach too, but he's in the hospital. And but man, let me tell you, man, tomorrow, pray for tomorrow, because we're coming back tomorrow.
Right.
We're going to have this fireworks. So just pray for us. God bless y'all. God love y'all, man. Hold your head up and keep the faith.
Right.
Sometimes we got to press on, man, because, you know, pride is not given to the swift, not to the strong, but the one endure to the end.
Yeah.
And another thing is this. The Bible said we got to work out our own salvation.
Yes, sir. Yes,
with fear and trembling.
Yes.
We got to go, man. But look here, man. I'm glad to be here one more time. And last night I didn't read the scriptures, but I want to be very sharp. I want to read this Matthew 6:33, because we want to move on. When I was in prison, man, now y'all don't know I've been to prison 4 different times. And I thank God. I couldn't say it at first, but now I can say I thank God for me coming to prison, and I thank God that he didn't get me out when I wanted to get out. But I'm glad to be out now. I'm off the road. I've been out 15 years.
That's
right. Second night out of Missionary Baptist Church, I went to that church when I first got out.
Right.
And I got out on a Friday. 2001, 2014 on a Saturday. I mean, 2001 on 14 was Sunday. I got out Friday, Sunday. I was in second month out.
All right.
And it really helped me, my brother. It helped me spiritually.
Yes, sir.
So my encouragement to y'all, brother, when you get out here, man, continue in the faith. Stay in the race. Do not get out the race. Stay in the race.
Right.
Don't get out, brother.
Right.
I'm telling you, brother.
Yeah.
If I didn't think it would be worth, brother, I wouldn't even waste my time coming down here, man.
Amen.
But I know Jesus works, man. He can work for you, man. If you trust him, surrender to him, he will work things out.
Yeah.
When man said it ain't gonna happen, God will make it happen.
Amen.
And you know why he'll make it happen? Because he got all power.
That's right.
All right, look. Matthew 6:33 says, but seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and everything will be added unto you. Let me tell you this here. When I was in prison, brother, I used to pray and ask God to help me. And this scripture came to me, and I read it. Then I read Matthew 6 chapter, a verse where it said, how you took care of the little bird.
Ooh, yeah.
Man, that really got to me. I said, no, Jesus took care of some birds in the grass on the field. How much more when he take care of me?
Yeah.
Now let me tell you this. I ain't never read nowhere in the Bible where he died for the bird.
Right.
All right, come on.
Yes. All right.
Have one of y'all ever read it?
Yeah.
I never read it.
Right.
And brother, he said, but seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And I told the Lord, I said, Lord, I want to put you first.
Yes.
Amen.
And right after I told the Lord that, I went up for parole and I made parole.
All right.
Got to put God first. And don't say what God can't do. Because I'm going to tell you something. When I got out of here, when God opened the door for me, after I put him first, I shine shoes. Y'all know that.
Yes.
And I love shining.
Yes.
And I know how to shine. And I'm not bragging, but I'm just testifying.
Yes.
I work at 2 banks right now.
Come on.
Shining shoes.
Oh. Ain't God good?
I went to the rodeo. I was out 8 months. Went to the rodeo, shined a man's shoe, he gave me a job working in the bank, worked there for 10 years, the bank paid me for 10 years, I was on parole then for robbery. I've been to prison 4 times, I've been twice for robbery, and God blessed me to get a job in the bank.
Yeah.
4 times. Yeah.
When you learn how to shine the shoes at?
In New Orleans. Yeah. And guess what? They ain't never asked me to fill out applications at the bank.
Come on.
I ain't never seen no application.
Yeah.
And I ain't won't see nothing.
Yeah.
All I want to do is shine some shoes and get out of there.
That's right.
But man, let me tell you something, man. The don't let people tell you what you ain't gonna do.
Yes.
What God can do it, man.
My God.
God can open doors for you, can no man shut. Yes. And I'm telling you, man, I'm still learning in the ministry. I ain't been serving the Lord all my life. I come out of the project, bro. Look here, I done did a little bit of everything. So this is something new to me.
Amen.
But I'm learning.
Amen.
To be content.
Yes.
I'm learning to not worry about man, because man ain't gonna let you die.
Oh yeah. All the time.
Yeah, they ain't gonna let you die. And like I said, brother, man, I'm so sorry that the choir didn't come, but hey.
You here.
I'm here.
Yes, my brother here.
And that's what counts. We got to do what God called us to do.
Yes,
we can invite people, bro. We can't make people do nothing.
That's right.
We can't make them.
Right.
Can nobody make you change? Can anybody make me change?
Right.
I wanted to change.
Amen.
Because I got tired of living the way I was living, man. I got tired of in and out of prison, in and out of jail. Man, I'm talking about, you know, I got tired.
Yes.
When you get tired, you're going to want some rest.
Yes,
right?
Yes,
except for that. When you get tired, you're going to want to lay down and go to sleep.
Yes.
Well, I got tired spiritually,
yes.
and I surrender, and brother, I want to do all I can,
all right.
For the Lord to encourage somebody else that is a better way. Y'all hold your head up, brother.
Yeah.
And look, man, notice here. God loves y'all, man. And because the Bible says when we were yet sinners, Christ died for us.
Yeah.
That means that before we even accepted Christ, before we even knew anything about Christ, when we was out there doing all that stuff, bro, he still had loved us.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Don't let nobody tell you about, they've been serving the Lord 40 years, God loved them more. They lying.
Yes.
All right.
He loves all us the same. In here, out there, wherever. And he, guess what? We serve a God to be everywhere at the same time. Because guess what? Before we got here, he was here.
Yes.
When we leave here, he's going with us.
He's here.
Oh, man. That's good news to know, man.
Yeah.
Good news, my brother.
Yes, Lord.
And you know what, man? I'm going to tell you this, and I'm going to be out the way. God blessed me when I got out of prison, man. And I asked God, I said, Lord, if this is what you want me to do, prison ministry, I need you to get me out. Before he got me out, I said, I need you to get me out first. And then bring me back in. But before you can bring me in, you got to get me out. And he got me out, man, let me tell you, man. And I start calling people to prison on the phone. And, man, they start. I said, I just come out, man, look, I've been in prison, I want to go back, I want to encourage somebody, and look like the Lord just, look like, when you want to come in over here?
Yeah.
When you want to come?
Right on.
Amen.
A lot of y'all might not know, I was right here on this unit.
Yes, sir. All right.
Working in the kitchen.
Testimony.
Coming to the second shift. Hey, I was right here on this unit, brother. Now I'm able to come, well, I had to walk on. Back then, you had to walk on that yellow line. But see, now, I don't walk on the yellow line anymore. And I'll be holding somebody that be in the middle with some authority, because guess what? I got some authority in Christ now.
Yeah.
I couldn't shut the gate behind myself. Now when I come in, I love to shit the game around the side.
When you click sound, you would just click.
I like to hear that because I couldn't do that one time.
No.
Right?
Amen.
Let me tell you something. The only reason why God helped us and to save us for us to help and save somebody else.
Yes, sir.
I've been out going on 16 years. I've been married 15 years. Everything we need, God got it. God will give it to us, my brothers. All we got to do is seek him first.
Yeah.
Put him first,
put him first.
And just do what we can to serve him, man. He got it, man.
Yes, sir.
He got it, my brother. Man, y'all brothers, I know y'all encouraged.
Yeah.
I know y'all encouraged.
Yes, yeah.
He encouraged. He can do it.
Yeah.
Put it first.
All right. All right.
Well, I did show up, and as much as I love seeing them guys come in and appreciate them coming in,
amen.
The importance of most important thing is not who's here on this side right here. It's not even most important that who's here right here. It's you guys right here. You guys right here. Because when it all said and done, they were here to bless us. And that's what these brothers are up here for too, to bless y'all. So God is trying to get guys and who's sitting right here to hear what he has to say. Whether he uses these brothers here, us up here, or whoever they come into. The fact that you're in your seats right now, that you're here, that's what God wanted. So I'm asking you to just open up your hearts and receive. And we're all proud to do what we always do. We're going to help y'all praise God with everything they have. Amen.
You thought I was to die for.
him kind of, but he say he sang too.
All right.
Yeah. And he's pretty
there's something about the name Jesus that will move mountains. There's something about the name Jesus that will call walls to fall down. There's something about the name Jesus that will turn your life around. If you believe it, shout hallelujah in this place.
That's the Lord. know that no matter what your enemy has stacked against you, that you just begin to tap into the Spirit of God, the very praise that He was ordained for us, that we can begin to allow His glory to be seated in our midst. Maybe you can't identify yet, but perhaps at this song, your heart may be rendered unto Him. Come on, let's give Him praise. Hallelujah. Bless your name. Oh,
I'm
in their circumstances. Know that no weapon that is formed against you that shall prosper, but every term that rises against you in judgment shall be condemned. So you might as well go ahead and begin to give God a praise right now. Somebody lift up your voices and say, praise Him, praise
Him.
Song.
I was coming here on tonight, I actually used my GPS, and I still got lost. I ended up somewhere down the road, another way, but I found somebody that helped me make it over here. What I said is that I wasn't going to go home. I was coming to see my brother. Somebody else would have said, well, I'm late, you know, well, I might as well just know. I said, I wasn't going home until I came to encourage my brother. That's why I'm here. And I have thoroughly enjoyed this choir. Oh, my God. I just want to just leave you with some encouraging words. Then, once I'm done, Minister Brooks, thank you for inviting me. Thank you for inviting me. But you know, I got lost on purpose.
Lost with a purpose.
I got lost on purpose.
Yes, sir. Man.
It was meant for me to get lost. Because if I didn't recognize I was lost, I wouldn't have recognized I needed to be found. And some people still don't know that they're lost. And it's even sadder to be lost and be in darkness, because I was lost and it was dark. But thank be to God that somebody found me. And I'm here. Let me share a word with you.
Come on, Doug.
Thank you, Lord. Take your time.
I want to just talk about, just for a few moments,
all right. Thank you, Lord.
Things that I must do.
All right.
Yeah. Because there's some things in life that I must do.
Yes, Lord.
Meaning that I don't have a choice in the matter.
No.
There's just some things that I
must do.
Amen. One of the things that I must do.
All right.
Is I must work the work. Of him. That sent me while it is day. Because when night comes, no man can work. And that is that you need to do all that you can while you can. Because there's going to come a time that you won't be able to do anything anymore. Every day that God allows us to wake up, it's another opportunity to be better. It's another opportunity to get stronger. It's another opportunity to get closer. It's another opportunity to love again. It's another opportunity to make it right. It's another opportunity to be forgiven. It's another opportunity to share some of the old stuff and accept the new. There's some things that I must do. Jesus said, I must work the work of him that sent me. But he said something else that he must do. He told Zacchaeus, he said that I must go home with you. And that is to say that God want you to take him everywhere you go. My mama used to sing a song when I was a little boy that she would say, take the Lord along with you everywhere you go. And this is why she said to take him, because you gonna need him. You gonna need him everywhere that you go. It's a dangerous thing to not know that you need the Lord. And we have to recognize that we need God every minute, every second, every hour of every day. In him I live, in him I move, in him I have my being. I can't think without him. I can't see without him. I can't breathe without him. I can't live without him. that I must go by Samaria.
All right.
He needed to go by Samaria because there was a woman that he had to meet at the well. And he asked her a question. He said, can you give me some water to drink? She looked at him and said, wait a minute, you a Jew. And I'm a Samaritan. And we don't have anything to do with each other. And Jesus looked at her and said, woman, if you knew who I was, come on, you be after me. And then he told her, go get your husband. And she says, I don't have a husband. He said, you have spoken truly because you've had six and the one that you're with don't belong to you. Well, you have to understand that numbers mean something with God. And if we all know that seven is the number of completion. And the reason why God stopped at six, because seven, he was going to become her new man. He was going to complete her life. He was going to complete her story. He was going to complete the ending of her sorrow. He was going to complete the end of her pain. He was going to complete the ending of her crying. Then she told, she said, I got to go to the house. And she ran and said, come see a man that told me all about myself. But the reason why he went is so we can kill our divides. Because we have to understand that whether we are black, whether we are white, whether we are rich, whether we are poor, that we're all in this thing together. We need each other to survive. We need each other to live another day. And so he let her understand that we can no longer live life like we've been living it before. The last thing he said is, I must go over to the other side. That's where I want to hang my hat. As they was getting ready to travel over to the other side.
Yes, Lord.
Yeah. It was not uncommon that they experienced storms.
Yeah.
Because they was always having some kind of storm. And the first time that Jesus was on the ship with them, and they began to feel the violence of the waves. And they asked him, they said, Master, do you care if we're going to perish? And they began to wake him up, and he stood up on the bow of the ship and he said, peace, be still. But this storm was a different storm. They went without Jesus. Somebody will get that in a minute. They went without Jesus. And it's a dangerous thing to think that you can make it without Jesus. They went traveling on the water to the other side. And here comes a storm. And the storm began to beat up on the ship. And the storm began to rock the ship. And water began to get on both sides. But the Bible said that Jesus came walking on the water. And when he came walking on the water, the Bible said that they became afraid because they thought it was a ghost. But Jesus kept walking. And as he was walking, somebody cried out and said, Lord, save me.
Save me, Lord.
I need you to save me. I'm in some violent storms, but I need you to save me. I've had some problems in my past, but I need you to save me. I've gone through life's ups and downs, but I need you to save me. My future don't look so bright and my past ain't that pretty, but I need you to save me. I can't tell sometimes where my friends are, but I need you to save me. I've had some lonely nights and some nights I've had to cry, but I need you to save me. I've been by myself sometimes and didn't know where help was coming from, but I need you to save me. What I love about the story, the Bible says that Jesus would have passed them by, except somebody cried out for him. He's passing by. All we have to do is cry out, call him by his name and say, Jesus, save me.
enough that they recognized it was Jesus. He told them, it's me. Don't be afraid. Be encouraged. Be strengthened. I know it looks dark right now, but be encouraged. Be strengthened. May not look all that good, but look, he said, be encouraged. Then Peter said, Lord, if it's you, let me come out there with you. Peter, you sure you want to come out of here? Because they never said that the rain ceased. Nor did the storm stop. But I can make it through the storm if I'm walking with Jesus. Peter understood something. Peter said, I'm safer in the storm with Jesus than I am on the boat. He said, I'm safer. I would rather step out in the water with Jesus. And as long as I'm with Jesus, everything. It's going to be all right. He stepped out there with Jesus. But you know, Peter reminds me of us. He began to look around.
He
said, wait a minute. This storm is real. This ain't for play. This is for real. This is some real stuff. Here, wait a minute. And just for a moment, he took his eyes off Jesus. And he began to sink. He began to go down. But watch this. He was close enough for Jesus to just reach out and grab him. See, it's one thing for me to call him and to wait on him to show up. But when I'm walking with him, and I'm talking with him. And if I fall, I don't have to call him now because he's right there to just pick me up. He reached down and grabbed Peter. And he was safe. And he walked him back to the boat. And they made it to the other side. I don't care what it looks like. We're going to make it to the other side. And I want you to tell somebody, say, you know what, my brother came by to see me today.
He's
going to say, well, I didn't know him before today, but my brother came by to see me. And my brother came to remind me that everything is going to be all right. He came to let me know that I'm not forgotten, that I'm not alone, that I'm not by myself. And sometimes we seem like we're all by ourselves. Nobody understands. But God allowed me to be lost. And he allowed somebody to find me. Just so I can come and tell you that I know what it feels like to be lost. And to not know where you are. But God will send somebody that will say, go down that street. Go through the light. Make a right and smile. Go up the road. And when you see the word a stale unit, hook a left. Come on down the way. And that's what God will do. He will tell you somebody will come along and say, just go down to the light and hook a right. But keep on praying. And keep on singing. And keep on playing. And keep on directing. And keep on singing. And keep on singing. And keep on praying. And keep on preaching.
Thank you.
while he's playing that, stay right there. I'm writing some right here. Everything is gonna be alright. Said everything is gonna be alright.
All right.
want you to be encouraged. No matter what's going on, I want you to stay strong. Stay strong in your mind. Stay strong in your heart. Stay strong in your faith. And believe that a brighter day is coming.
Thank you.
And you just blessed me.
Oh, yeah. brother.
All right, that's all right.
Desperately waiting.
I'm desperately waiting.
we have experienced God in an awesome way on tonight. Share with your partner, your friend next thing, just say, we serve.
We serve
an awesome God. And if you know that our God is awesome, clap for God. Lift your voice. Give him praise. Give him glory. 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 Said every song sang. Let it be encouragement. Let it be strength. Let it be what we need it to be. Keep us as our prayer. In the name of Jesus. Until we come together again for the purpose to give you glory, we say thank you, Father. 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 In Jesus' name. Come on, let's give God a shout.